80s radio hit to kick off our Ace Attorney evening. Yeah, that's I Just Died in Your Arms by Cutting Crew, coming off their 1986 album Broadcast. Hey y'all, it's been a long time since we've had a late Blue Jay stream. It has been a very long time. It is currently 10:19 p.m. Central here in the DFW area, May 13th, 2022, on this beautiful Friday night. Oh man, dude. I'm so stoked. It's so weird doing a stream at around this time. Like, I can't remember the last time we've done this. This is fun. This is really fun. Well, shoot, y'all. We started Ace Attorney last week, and I'm loving it so far. We finished the first, let me switch here. Now I can see everybody. We finished the first chapter. We are now on chapter two. It's getting down to the nitty gritty. We're actually making moves now. And let's see where we left off, because it's been a little bit. Let's see where we left off. I don't want to use network features. Update later. What features are there? Ace Attorney Battle Royale. Yeah, you face off against 100 other lawyers. Doesn't that sound fun? Doesn't that sound fun? Also, by the way, we got Torlin in chat. Good to see you. We got Brydeck in chat. Good to see you. Chickwit. Good to see you, Chickwit. We got Saber. Hey. We got Saber. And my new friend, Hectic. Good to see you, Hectic. And your wonderful GF, if they're here listening in. Good to see you as well. Good to see you as well. it was nice meeting y'all this evening. Very good burgers. Really good burgers. Really good burgers. For real though, really good burgers. I love the hell out of them. I will definitely be getting that same burger next time I go. Legit. Welcome to the community. This is it. This is what I do every day, right? Or every other day. No, every day. I take 2 days off, or one. I'm rambling. It's good to see y'all. Glad y'all are here. Also, Fanity, good to see you. Everyone else is starting to pour on in. Whether you're going to be chatting with us, maybe you're going to be listening in with the lurk, or watching from. You will not be watching from the future. Maybe you will. Because, you know, the VOD will stay up on Twitch, but once it's gone, it's gone. So, most days. There you go, Fanity, most days. That's a better way to put it. Also, Saber, good to see you. Almost thought you weren't going to stream it tonight after all. No, man, no, absolutely. I should have let y'all know in the Discord. I was just having a really good dinner, meeting two new wonderful people through my wife. Co-worker and co-worker's boyfriend. And they introduced us to a really good burger place. Really good burger place. And I'm not just saying that because that's the name of the restaurant, but it was really good. Really good. So good that I will definitely be getting that burger again. But it had like jalapenos and habanero. It had like a habanero like sauce or something. I don't know. It was like a habanero sauce with jalapenos and it had bacon and onions. And it was just like this. It was good. It was freaking good. And, had a really good glass of Coke with it, too. It was just perfect. It was perfection. We're having such good conversations, though. We totally forgot that they had ordered fried pickles. And I finally got to the fried pickles after they had gotten cold. And I was just like, oh, I completely forgot about the fried pickles. But it was good. It was really good. I keep saying that. I'm not punning. It really is good. Anyways, enough about me and my burger experience tonight. It was great. I got to press the X button, you see. So I'm going to press that button. I'm gonna take a sip of my water. All right. Why don't I hear the audio? There we go. The name of the place is Really Good Burger? Audacious. I know. Oh, yes, the Turnabout Sisters. Yes, that's where we're at the moment. Introducing one of the sisters. She's all nya nya and shit. You know, it's like that. So basically, there's been a murder. And I think she did it. But we're not going to jump to conclusions. Not going to jump to conclusions. But I will say the murder involved someone that our character, Phoenix Wright, knew. It was basically the person that trained us. We were their apprentice. And they were murdered in cold blood. Murdered. And this character's sister, the person who got murdered. In fact, I will show you this character. Let's go to move. So yeah, this poor individual, the person that we were apprenticing to, or apprenticing with, that's her younger sister. And she was there when it all happened, and she's being framed for the murder. And, yeah, it's no good. It's no good. So that said, we've already explored all this. I think we were just finishing Gatewater Hotel. In fact, yeah, I think we're getting ready to move over to the law offices, which is where we're hopefully going to find... what's her name? Is her name Faye, I think? Is that right? I gotta remind myself. Can someone remind me the name of the sister? What was her name? Well, basically, she was looking for a specific lawyer, so I think we gotta go over to these law offices to go find said lawyer to defend her. But it most likely is going to be us. Seems like Mr. Grossberg is out. Well, maybe I should just wait here for him to come back. Where did I get Faye from? Mia is dead, which was the person that we were apprenticing with. And Maya has been framed, which is the sister of Mia. Thank you very much, Brydeck. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. Torland, if she did it, she is in great shape to have run all the way back to the hotel room to be a witness. You know, that's a good point. That's a very good point. I'm sure she has something to do with it, though. At the very least. Faye is their last name. Okay, good. So I wasn't crazy. There was something to it there. If that wasn't the most over-the-top clearing of the throat I've ever heard.
Oh, yeah. You're the one they say has been looking for me.
Yes, that's me. He looks even grander than I imagined.
That badge on your collar. Ah, so you're a lawyer, are you now?
Yes.
And what do you want? I'm not particularly busy these days. Please proceed.
Not busy? Then how come no one could get in touch with you? Hey, this is on my mind, I should probably pull up my notes from last time, because I did take notes. I have been taking notes. Let me go to my notes. Game notes. I did not file it correctly. Where did I put my notes? Oh, God. What did I do with my Ace Attorney notes? I don't know where I saved them. Why aren't they in my notes folder like they should be? Well, friends, I don't know what I did with my Ace Attorney notes. Hey, wait, maybe I can look up recents. Oh, you can't. Well, I'll make new notes. Whoops.
Something the matter. You come to see the one and only Marvin Grossberg, did you not? Well, here I am, boy. What do you want? Out with it.
Well, sir, actually, it's about Maya. Maya Faye?
Yes, Maya Faye. Go on.
Why the strange reaction?
I'm really quite busy here, son. I can't go talking cases or taking cases on a day's notice. No, it's quite impossible.
Wait a second. How did you know the trial was tomorrow?
None of your tinder. Anyway, I'm afraid it's entirely impossible for me to represent her. Sorry. End of discussion.
How did Grossberg know the trial was tomorrow, even though he says he doesn't have time? or something. What's going on? He refused me even before I got a chance to ask him. What do I tell Maya? We'll represent her. We got this. Didn't you write it on an already existing document for something else, or am I making that up? This is good music for checking to see if I wrote notes on another document. Hang on, you might be onto something there. Dude, I'm gonna geek if I find it. Hold on. I don't have very many, so I'm just gonna quickly open these. Yes, where are the notes? What did I do with them? Oh God. What's something that I often write in? Version numbers, don't forget these. No, I opened that today. It wouldn't be that one. Brand book, maybe? No. Outriders, maybe? Very good point. I do have the Outriders notes. No, not in there. What did I do with the damn things? I'm so confused. I'm so good about filing stuff. Like, why did I not file this one? Your live journal? I've never had one. I never did have a live journal. That was never my thing. I don't think I know anybody who's ever had a live journal. Personally. Maybe one of you have had one. I don't know. Anywho. We should start by examining the room. That painting has been bugging me ever since I stepped in here. Why? The oil paint is so thick, it's practically giving me a stuffed nose. Oh, okay. Understandable. I'm sure the price is nothing to sneeze at either, for that matter. Is that a pun? Is that a pun about sneezing and nose stuffing? Phoenix, you're a very funny guy, so. Expensive-looking mahogany bookshelves, filled with expensive-looking books. Funny. They don't look like they've ever been read. Yes, decorative books. I know what you mean. I did for roleplay. I know that was one of the applications for Live Journal. I think that's one of the things it was known for, was for the roleplay communities. It died a long time ago, I think. Pre-Blogger, WordPress, etc. Really? Surely it's still around, is it? I wonder. Yeah, I never got into that. I missed out on that train. A solid mahogany desk. The wood's been polished to a deep luster. Yeah, something about mahogany in here. Lots of mahogany. An expensive potted plant. No idea what kind of plant it is, but it's probably the most expensive one available. A table for clients. An elegant ebony case. And if I'm not mistaken, that lighter's made of solid gold. Even I could tell someone here's got money to burn. Very much of interest in here. Let me just kind of scroll around a little more. I think that about tears it. Okay. Let's talk to the guy. Let's discuss his refusal. How could you just refuse like that? Please, tell me why you won't take the case.
Well, you see, it's just, I'm busy, you see.
But the client is Mia Faye's sister.
Mia trusted you. She knew her
Mia trusted you. She knew her sister would be in good hands.
Yes, of course, I know that. However, I'm sorry, but I must refuse. Sorry, goodbye.
Is he representing the murderer? Or the other? Nah, that... Creep. Fine. I don't have time to argue with you anyway. I'll go look elsewhere. Damn, you called him a creep, though.
I think not.
Huh? Did you say something?
I think not, I said.
But what do you mean?
I'm terribly, terribly sorry. But I'm afraid that no lawyer worth their salt will take on this particular case. Terribly sorry, my boy.
Why?
I cannot say it.
You're saying too much, Grossberg.
I beg your pardon, but could you leave now? I've nothing more to discuss with you.
What if they're buying out these lawyers? the culprits.
What's going on here?
That's very curious. Very curious indeed. How did you know Mia Fey?
She worked here a long time ago. Quite the apprentice, that one. Learned my techniques in the blink of an eye. She left one day quite suddenly. She had a mission, you see.
A mission?
You could see it in her eyes. She followed it with a burning passion. Never looked back, that one.
So that's interesting to note. Okay, let's talk about the painting, I guess? That's quite a painting.
You noticed? It's my pride and joy. Impressive, isn't it? Well, isn't it? The color of the sky, the hue of the sea, the weave of the straw hat. It's worth at least $3 million. I have no intention of parting with it, of course. No, I won't sell it. Not even to you.
I wasn't interested.
It's not for sale. I'm not buying.
Oh, I'm not buying. Jeez. Yes, a conspiracy, no doubt. No lawyer worth their salt, says Torlin. If they are being bought by the culprit or something, I highly doubt that they are good lawyers worth their salt. True. That's a very good point. It's a good point. Very curious indeed. Should I present him evidence? Let's just show him some stuff.
Very sorry, but I've got nothing to say regarding this matter.
Okay, he doesn't like my badge. How about this?
Very sorry, but I... All right. Very sorry. Okay. Very sorry, but...
All right, yeah. He doesn't want to say anything. Okay, I think we're done here. So, let's go... Oops. Let's go talk to... I guess we should tell her the news, yeah. September 6th, 3:42 p.m. Detention Center, Visitor's Room. Alright, let's see what happens. Hiya. Oh, you're back! Did you find the lawyer? Well... What do I tell her? Well, see... Just be honest. I really don't think you should use that guy. Oh, the way she sulked. He didn't really seem healthy. He was all skin and bones. Be honest, he said. What really happened? You don't mean he refused to help? I see. I've been abandoned then. Damn, son! It's so sad. Her expressions, bro. Huh. Well, let's talk about her family. Oh, we did examine them. Yeah, we got it. That's a good thing you mentioned, though. But yeah, we got it. I moved the cursor everywhere. I think we got it. I hope so. What about your family? I only had my sister. My father died when I was very young. And I don't know where my mother is. Don't know. So she could still be alive?
Well, let's talk about that.
The women in my family have been mediums for generations. Right, she's a medium. I forgot about that. Medium in training. They say a lot of spiritual power runs in our blood. About 15 years ago, our family was involved in an incident. There was a man, and he ruined our mother's life.
Ruined?
After that, she disappeared. Several years after that, my sister announced she would become a lawyer, and she left the mountain.
So you live by yourself?
Yes, I've gotten used to it. Oh, also, I had to become independent, or I would lose my powers. I feel bad for her, all by herself up on that mountain.
Let's talk about the mother's enemy.
So, who was this man who, ruined your mother? About 15 years ago, there was an unusual murder case.
It made quite a stir. Everyone was talking about it, apparently. The police were running out of leads, and they were getting desperate.
Wait, they didn't use a spirit medium? Did they?
The police convinced my mother to try to contact the victim.
Wow, so what happened?
The case was solved, we thought.
You thought?
The man my mother helped the police capture was innocent. The police's consultation with the medium had all been carried out in secret, of course. But a man found out about it and leaked it to the press. He told all the papers that my mother was a fraud, and the media jumped on it big time. My mother became the laughingstock of the nation.
I see.
White.
Excuse me? White?
That was his name, my sister told me.
White.
Just a little longer now before the state-appointed lawyer comes, I guess.
4 p.m. Time's up. What should I do? Do I just leave her and go home?
Nah, bro. We gotta defend Maya, bro!
I've made up my mind. I'm going to defend you whether you want me to or not.
Why?
Why? Well...
Give me a drink of water.
I can't abandon you, I'll say that. No one is as sad as a person without any friends. I know, I've been there, a long time ago. Oh! Why did I become a lawyer in the first place? Backstory, kind of? Oh, I know, her reaction is just like, frozen. Shocked. Because someone has to look out for the people who have no one on their side. Maya, I won't abandon you. You can count on me.
That's so kind of you.
Damn, she's crying though. Well, let's fight this one and get you out of here. Yes.
Right, thank you.
Whew, she smiled at last. She looks like an entirely different person. One last question. You are innocent, right?
Yes.
And I trust you. So you trust me too, okay? It's a deal. So, what next? There's something that's been bugging me.
Yeah, she's bugging me too.
Just what was inside that strange woman's drawer? A screwdriver, obviously. It was when I tried to look into the drawer that she got all defensive. So, for those who don't know, in the scene when we discovered, the murder, or like the aftermath of said murder, we tried to use the phone and found that it had been messed with. It had been tampered, unscrewed. Screwdriver! What's that doing here? You know? There has to be something in there. Okay. Yes, yes. We're gonna use that emote a lot at this game, aren't we? Yes. Yes, indeed. Dude, that smile is like so genuine though. Okay. Don't think there's much else for us to examine. Did I show her the phone? Oh wait, we did. We did do that already. I wonder if this is relevant now. Maybe. Okay, never mind. Yeah, I think we're good. We've done every prompt, we've shown her everything, we've talked to everybody, I believe. No more extra stuff here. I think we're ready to move on. Whatever that means. Yeah, I don't think there's much else for us to see here. Alright, I guess we go back to the hotel?
Good afternoon, sir.
Excuse me, you are?
Ah, I beg your pardon, sir. I am the bellboy of this establishment, at your service, sir.
Oh, right.
I've just come up to deliver room service, sir.
Do you know where Miss May might be?
I believe our guest Miss May is currently using the, facilities? If you've no need of anything, I'll be taking my leave. Please, stay as long as you like. Enjoy!
Yeah. Wait, no, hey! Why does it seem like every time I come here, I end up embarrassing myself? Wait, now is my chance to snoop around a bit. Now we can check out the screwdriver. I almost forgot! You bastard! He's back! You came back quick! Might I ask you to inform Miss May that there is a message for her? Please tell her that Mr. White... Nunny. Mr. White. Of Blue Corp phoned. Oh, right. Sure. Mr. White? Of Blue Corp? Where have I heard that name? You know where you've heard that name, guy. All right, hold on. Let me organize my notes here. Grossberg notes. And then, Pink Girl notes. Okay, so, a phone call for her from the Mr. White. Blue Corp. Okay. White. That was his name. My sister told me. White was the name of the guy who ruined Mia and Maya's mother. Could it be a coincidence? I think not. Okay, we gotta quickly examine. Starting with the screwdriver. There's a screwdriver sticking out of that half-open drawer. Now's my chance to see what's inside. What do we have here? Ah, wiretap. What would a woman like her be doing with a thing like this? Okay. We got a wiretap, everybody. Jesse, let's cook. I've not seen the show, but I know what you're doing. I know exactly what you're doing. There's definitely something suspicious about this Miss May. Why would she have anything like this in her hotel room? There's a story behind all this. I know it. All right. I'll be using this bit of evidence in tomorrow's trial. That's for sure. For Maya's sake. I'll get to this woman's bottom. Wait, no. I mean, you know what I mean. Bruh. Oh, bellboy! Still there? Uh-oh. Time to scram! I look forward to tangoing with you tomorrow, Miss May. Oh my god, I forgot that he says stuff like this. In court! Yeah. To be continued? Really? Oh. Yeah, save my progress. Damn. All right, day two, the trial. Oh, I'm ready. I'm ready. September 7th, 10 a.m. District Court, courtroom number one. Sorry, I tripped over my words.
Court is now in session for the trial of Miss May Maya Faye.
I keep messing up names, sorry.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor. Miles Edgeworth. I'd better not show any signs of weakness today, or he'll be on me in an instant.
Mr. Edgeworth, please give the court your opening statement.
Thank you, Your Honor. The defendant, Miss Maya Faye, was at the scene of the crime. The prosecution has evidence she committed this murder. And we have a witness who saw her do it. The prosecution sees no reason to doubt the facts of this case, Your Honor.
I see.
Thank you, Mr. Edgeworth. Let's begin then. If we may call our first witness, Your Honor. The prosecution calls the chief officer at the scene, Detective Gumshoe.
Oh, it's him.
Witness, please state your name and profession to the court.
I think there is an anime for this. Can y'all confirm or deny?
Sir, my name's Dick Gumshoe, sir. I'm the detective in charge of homicides down at the precinct, sir.
Detective Gumshoe, please describe for us the details of this murder.
Very well, sir. Let me use this floor map of the office to explain. The body was found in this by this window here. And the cause of death? Oh, and the cause of death? Lots of blood, loss of blood, due to being struck by a blunt object, sir. The murder weapon was a statue of the Thinker found next to the body, sir. It was heavy enough to be a deadly weapon, even in a girl's hands, sir. The court accepts the statue as evidence.
They're still calling it a statue. For those who don't know, in the last trial, the first one, we discovered, well, someone had murdered someone using a similar statue. The same statue, actually. And it's not just a statue, it's actually a clock that we discovered. So you turn it upside down, it tells the time. So the person that was killed in the last trial, their boyfriend had made that particular thing. He made two of them, actually. One for him and then one for her, I believe. As like a memento, something they could keep together. So we ended up giving the other one, the one that wasn't used as a murder weapon, to the woman who was murdered in this case as like a gift. And turns out the murderer of that woman used that very statue. So it's like, once again, we're dealing with this statue. But remember, it is a clock as well. I don't know if that's going to come back, but we should keep that in mind, I suppose. So we got floor plans added to the court record. That's good. Now, detective. Ooh, that's a good look. That is a good look, Mr. Edgeworth. I like this guy.
Yes, sir.
You immediately arrested Miss Maya Fey, who was found at the scene, correct? Can you tell me why?
Yes, sir. I had hard evidence she did it, sir. Detective Gumshoe, please testify to the court about this hard evidence.
Here we go. Let me get ready for this.
As soon as the phone call came in, I rushed to the scene. There were two people there already. The defendant, Miss Maya Fey, and the lawyer, Mr. Phoenix Wright. I immediately arrested Miss Maya Fey. Why, we had a witness account describing her.
So, for those who don't know as well, the building where the murder took place across the street was that hotel that we visited with the screwdriver. She was in there, and she happened to witness the murder from across the way. Right? Now, I don't know why she had the screwdriver, but it was in her hotel room. So this is, that's what we know so far.
The witness saw Miss Maya Fey at the very moment of the murder. The very moment, you say. Very well, Mr. Wright. You may begin your cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor. Cross-examine what? I couldn't see a single contradiction in that testimony. Whoosh.
Smack!
Hey, Maya just threw something at me. What's this? Well, my sister couldn't find any contradictions in a witness testimony. She would bluff it and press the witness on every detail. The witness always slips up and says something wrong. It worked lots of times. Huh. I should have expected Maya would know some of her sister's tricks. Alright, let's give this a try. So we're gonna press him on every detail. Sounds good.
Something the matter?
No, Your Honor. I'd like to begin my cross-examination. All right. Let us begin. So as soon as the phone call came in, I rushed to the scene. All right, well, let's go ahead and question him on it, right?
Hold it!
Who did you say you got a call from?
Hey, pal, don't play dumb. You know who. The call was from a customer at the Gatewater Hotel, right across the crime scene.
Okay, I pressed. Not sure it did much, though. Right, please continue. Okay. Okay. So nothing contradicting in the first one. I'm gonna write down details as I go. So got call from the hotel girl. There were two people there already. Detective Gumshoe, how long would you say it took between you receiving the call and your arrival at the scene of the crime?
Right. I'd say it was about 3 minutes.
That's pretty fast.
Our motto this month is quick response. That's how I got there before the killer got away.
Indeed. So, tell us who the two people you found on the scene were.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Arrived 3 minutes after the call.
Hold it!
Are you absolutely sure it was us? Okay, so we're questioning him on the thing saying that it was me and Mia, right? Are you absolutely sure it was us?
Listen, pal, your dumb act will only get you so far. With her funky hippie clothes and your spiky hair.
Hippie clothes?
You two stand out like suspicious people at a crime scene.
Well, he does have a point about her. She is pretty unmistakable. I should pick my points to press with a little more care. Okay. Unmistakable outfits for us. These things may not matter in the end, but I'm going to detail them anyways.
I immediately arrested Miss Maya Fey.
Hold it!
Why is that? What's your reason?
Why? We had a witness account describing her.
Oh. We had a witness account describing her. Okay. This could be interesting.
Hold it!
Hold on just 1 second.
Yeah?
If I heard correctly, you said you arrested her because you had hard evidence she did it, correct?
Huh? Did I say that? Me?
I heard you say it.
You did say it.
You said it. I love this game! That's great. Exactly what about this suspicious woman in Pink's claim was hard evidence?
What? Miss May isn't suspicious, and she sure isn't Pink, pal. Well, I guess she is Pink. Well, that's enough. Detective Gumshoe, do you have any more solid proof other than her claims, Detective?
I guess pressing can have its advantages.
Yes! Sorry, I got the order of things mixed up with my testimony, Your Honor, sir. There was something I should have told you about at first, Your Honor. Very well, Detective. Let's hear your testimony again.
Okay. So, what we just gathered is, basically, the hard evidence that he had was just off of hearsay from the person that was across the way. So, he didn't have any real hard evidence at all. So, we got that through. So, let's go ahead and move on to the next bit. All right.
After securing the suspect, I examined the scene of the crime with my own eyes. I found a memo written on a piece of paper next to the victim's body. On it, the word Maya was written clearly in blood. Lab test results showed that the blood was the victim's. Also, there was blood found on the victim's finger. Before she died, the victim wrote the killer's name. How you like that? That's my hard evidence. Before we begin cross-examination, I have a question for you, Detective. Your Honor? Why didn't you testify about the vital piece of evidence the first time? I know. I'm real embarrassed I forgot about it, Your Honor, sir.
That's very convenient that you would forget about the thing that had blood on it, you know?
Try to be more careful. Very well. The defense may begin its cross-examination.
All right, Judge. Let's get into it. All right. After securing the suspect, I examined the scene of the crime with my own eyes. Well, I guess we'll do the same thing.
Hold it!
And did you find any evidence?
Now, don't jump the gun on me, pal. Just listen, I'm getting the good part. Getting to the good part.
I got a bad feeling about this. Okay, hold on. Maybe I shouldn't present any of this yet? Okay, we also should remember this. Let me think about this. Okay, so single blunt force trauma, just one hit. Why would the victim... or why would the murderer write their own name on the receipt and stay in the scene, right? Like... I don't know. Let me just press on this. Let's see what happens. Just because you found it next to the body doesn't mean the victim wrote it. Which, yeah, that's like the obvious thing, right?
Then who did write it, smarty pants?
Who? How would she write the name if she was killed instantly? That's the thing, right? So I wouldn't be Miss May. But then again, hold on. Death was instantaneous, so she didn't have time to write. Yeah, like what you're saying, she didn't have time to write the name. Somebody, okay. We must remember, Mr. White. There's a potential that Mr. White did this. There's a chance that he had a hit on this, on Miss May. So, he would probably want to frame the sister to make this whole thing get worse. So yeah, it would be the killer. I don't think this is gonna help anything, but it would be the killer. The killer! Anyone could see that.
Huh. You're saying the killer wrote her own name? Buddy, please.
Oh. But we also must remember that the person that's being convicted is considered the killer right now. Right? She was framed. Oh, thank you, Phoenix. Thank you for saying what I wanted to say.
Objection!
Ooh. Hold on. If that's the case, where's your evidence? God. Uh-oh.
Ha! I guess that was a bit of a tall order for you. Those without evidence shouldn't open their mouths, Mr. Wright. Yeah, pal. Ugh. Well, detective, tell us what's written on that memo you found.
Okay, we didn't get any penalties, but... so far, so good, right? Huh.
Do you have proof it was Mia who wrote that? Of course I do, pal.
Uh-oh. He sounded pretty confident. This might not be good. All right, the lab test results showed that the blood was the victim's. It is helping me craft the defense theory. That's true. That's true. All right, let me think about this. The lab test results showed that the blood was the victim's. So whoever did it would have used the victim's blood right to write the name. Obviously, right? Right. But does that prove that it was Maya who did it? No. But we have to find a way to prove it. How do we prove that Mia was the one, or Maya was the one who wrote her own? I mean, it doesn't make sense, right? I don't know. Let me just press. We just gotta find something that's gonna prove. What kind of tests were these again?
Well, what kind? Well, I hear they take the, little bits in the blood, the, hermogoblins, hermogoblin blobbin. I refuse to testify on this matter, pal.
He got frustrated.
I'm no expert on blood tests. Yes, that was quite clear. You may continue with your testimony. Thanks, pal. I mean your honor, sir. Detective Gumshoe. Yeah? I look forward to your next evaluation, as should you.
Ooh, Edgeworth. He's kind of shunning his witness there. That was a mess.
Right! Where was I?
Okay. So he doesn't know what he's talking about, but all right. I almost wish it didn't show you all the testimony first. The cross-examination is written to make sense as if you were injecting in real time. True, that is a good point. That is a good point. That is a good point. Because we are kind of going through it again. But, anywho. Hey! Good morning, Sonny. Good to see you. There was blood found on the victim's finger. But that doesn't prove that Maya did it. Or, yeah. Ha, how do we prove that she didn't do that?
Hold it!
On which hand was the bloody finger, Detective? Ah, good question, Phoenix.
The right hand.
She was right-handed.
Nice try.
Uh-oh. I guess it wasn't too hard to see what I was getting at there. Damn. Let's see. Before she died, the victim wrote the killer's name.
Hold it!
Detective Gumshoe, do you get a lot of cases where the victim actually writes the killer's name?
Sure, it happens all the time in books and in movies.
Gumshoe, you're my opponent, and I'm just like, no. Books and movies? This isn't a movie, Detective. Let's talk about a reality, shall we?
I guess. I haven't heard of many cases, no.
Don't you find it a little odd that the victim would write down a name? Especially the name of her own sister. Right.
You got a point, pal.
Objection!
I was waiting for that. Stop right there. That little head shake he does. The witness's opinion on the matter is irrelevant. The facts are clear. The victim wrote down the name of the accused. The victim told us the name of her killer. But she died instantly! She couldn't have done it!
Order! Order!
That didn't go so well.
That's right! What he said!
That's his whole testimony. Okay, there has to be a contradiction in there somewhere. There is! And I know what it is! Okay, we gotta go all the way to the end. Okay, before she died, the victim wrote the killer's name. The autopsy proves that she died instantly. She couldn't have done that. Thank goodness we have that. Right here.
Objection!
Detective Gumshoe, there's one thing I want you to clarify for me here. You say that the victim, Mia Fey, wrote this note. That she was accusing the defendant, Maya Fey. That's really what you're saying.
What? This isn't one of those lawyer tricks now, is it?
Of course she wrote it! Who else could have?
You have it backwards, Detective.
Backwards?
The victim is the only person who absolutely could not have written it. This is a report from your department, Detective. Immediate death due to a blow from a blunt object. She died immediately.
But...
No butting your way out of this one, Detective.
Order! Order!
The defense has a point. Someone who died immediately wouldn't have the time to write anything down.
Objection!
Mr. Wright, I beg your pardon, but when exactly did you obtain that autopsy report?
Misho, thanks for the 100, dude. Oh yeah, I know, I like the way he slaps it. He's like, the paper, you see. Yeah, Misho. Good to see you, dude. Thanks for the 100. I appreciate you. But yeah, I beg your pardon. But when exactly did you obtain that autopsy report?
When?
Fuck. When did we get the autopsy report?
It would have been the day after the murder.
It was the day after the murder.
The prosecution's point being...
That autopsy report is outdated, Your Honor.
But what?
A second autopsy was performed yesterday, at my request. A second autopsy was performed yesterday at my request.
You bastard!
Death was almost immediate due to a blow from a blunt object. It's amazing how one word, almost. Just like a prosecutor withholding evidence. Yeah, can we challenge him on that? Hey! But there is a possibility the victim lived for several minutes after the blow. I'm turning this down because I did remember something. When the cutscene happened where she was murdered, there was a point where, and I don't know if this is going to be relevant, it may not be, but I do remember Phoenix going up to her, noticing that there was still warmth in her hand, and then it slowly started to fade to cold, which implies that she was still alive. She may not have been completely conscious, but I don't know if that helps us, but I do remember that happening. I don't know. Let's just see where this goes. I received these results this morning. No way! Your Honor, it's quite easy to imagine that the victim did have time to write Maya. That is all.
I see. Damn you, Edgeworth. I should have known you'd have something like this up your sleeve.
Why, Mr. Wright, you look shocked. Something you want to say?
They could hold me into contempt for this, right? I'm not a sham. The you withheld evidence. You're a sham, Edgeworth.
Mr. Edgeworth, I've heard there's nothing you won't do to get your verdict.
What reason could you possibly have to request a second autopsy report?
Mr. Wright, the defense will refrain from personal attacks on the prosecution.
No matter, Your Honor.
Mr. Wright, say what you will. The evidence in this report is undeniable. Your Honor, I submit this report to the court.
Understood. The court accepts this evidence.
All right. We got updated evidence, I guess. I'm a sham? Should I have said that? Like...
Well, Your Honor,
the evidence strongly suggests the victim was identifying the killer.
I suppose that's the obvious conclusion, yes.
Oh, sorry. I suppose that's the obvious conclusion, yes.
It is a funny option.
Darn, this isn't good.
The prosecution would like to call its next witness. This poor innocent girl saw the murder with her own eyes.
Oh, God. It's her. Here we go.
Let the witness, Miss April May, take the stand. Miss April May.
Yes. Exactly what part of her is innocent? All right.
Witness, your name, please. I've unlocked a meme, Torlin?
Have I?
I want to see.
Guys, I've unlocked a meme. I've unlocked a meme, everybody. I want to see it. I want to see the meme. I'm going to pull it up, okay? Okay. Okay.
When you update the autopsy report.
I like the, well, you're wrong, little bitch. Like, oh. I think he called him gumfuck, too. Very good. Very good. Very good. Tell your friends. Tell your friends.
I'm glad we earned that. Thank you, Toro. That's good.
Hey. Hey, those are good goals, though. Unlocking memes. I like that. Once we reach certain points of the game, we can unlock memes. I look forward to more. All right, it's time for the one and only. Witness your name, please.
April May, at your service, wink.
Oh, God. Jiggle physics in my Phoenix Wright game.
Order! An introduction should not require any reaction from the crowd.
What kind of reaction,
The witness will refrain from wanton winking.
Wanton winking? Wanton? Wanton? Wanton?
Aw, yes, Your Honor.
This is not good. She's already captured the heart of every man in this courtroom. It could be women too, right? I mean, come on.
Tell us, where were you on the night of September 5th when the murder occurred?
Gee, I was, like, in my hotel room. I checked in right after lunch.
And this hotel is directly across from the Fay and Company law offices.
That's right, big boy.
Please testify to the court about what you saw.
Alrighty then. Oh, she's captured those hearts, too. Yes. Yes, she has.
It was, like, 9 at night. I looked out the window, you know. And then, oh, I saw a woman with long hair being attacked. The one attacking her was the mousy girl sitting in the defendant's chair. Then the woman, like, dodged to one side and ran away. But that girl, she caught up to her and she hit her. Then the woman with the long hair, she kinda slumped. The end. That's all I saw. Every little bitsy witsy.
Oh, God. She's fun.
Well, Your Honor, I see. It is a remarkably solid testimony. I don't see a need to trouble the witness any...
Wait, Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. Wright.
What about my cross-examination?
I thought the witness's testimony just now was quite firm, didn't you?
Mr. Wright, I understand you were Miss Mia Fey's understudy, were you not? You must know her techniques well. Her cowardly way of finding tiny faults in perfectly good testimonies.
Hey, how dare you?
Well, Mr. Wright, will you cross-examine the witness?
Yes!
I'll gladly proceed with the cross-examination. If only because I have a feeling Edgeworth doesn't want me to.
Out of spite!
She has to have some weakness.
Very well, you may begin your cross-examination.
All right, let's get to work. Ha.
It was like 9 at night. I looked out the window, you know?
All right, what do we have here? Died from a blow by a blunt object. May have lived for a few minutes after being hit. May have, right? I'm glad we mentioned that. May have. Ooh, okay, it's a good thing we have this layout. Okay, in terms of the body slumping, right? How could she have seen the slumping, right? Because the body was against the window, unless she was standing up against the window and then slumped down from against the window. But I don't know. It looked like she was already down when it happened, right? Window, which is where she would have seen it. There's the shards of glass where things were broken. She was on the floor in the middle. Right here. Not a terrible view. We'll see. We'll keep that notion in mind. Let's go ahead and start by pressing here. Why did you do that? Huh? Why? Like, why what? Why did you look out the window? Were you expecting to see something?
Oh, well, gee. What? That's it? She can't get out of this question that easily. I sort of, you know. I had a feeling.
You butthead! You butthead, I had a feeling. Get out of here! She's obnoxious, but I love this character, actually. Just the little, like, you know. I had a feeling, like. Well, I have a feeling she's trying to avoid the question. Star witness, that's right. Maybe I should press a little harder on this one. Let's go for it. Let's see how far I can run with this. Surely you must have had a reason to look out your window at that time of night. Mr. Wright, I will not have you badgering my witness. Badgering? You insist on needling her with these trivial questions. I really don't think it should be allowed. Yeah, stop him! Oh, the poor girl. Oh, God.
Order! Mr. Wright, you have been warned.
Poor girl? What about poor me? You looked out the window. What did you see next? Woo! We didn't get penalized, though, so that's good. Okay, I saw a woman with long hair being attacked. The woman with long hair. That was Mia Fey. Slender, sorta. Well, some people might say pretty, if that's your thing. Your thing. And the person attacking her. The one attacking her was the mousy girl sitting in the defendant's chair. How do you know she was the defendant? Huh? Well, you know, she had a girlish physique. Women know these things. Look, I just know, okay? There was only one person at the scene of the crime with a short, girlish figure. The testimony is bulletproof, Your Honor. He's right. I mean, yeah. Well. Given what we know so far, it was most likely would have had to do with Mr. No, okay, I don't think Mr. White necessarily did it. I think he probably, whoever this white guy is, probably executed the hit, asked somebody to do the hit, right? If there was a girl, okay. Going off the context of the name of this chapter, it probably had to do with the twin. There's a twin, right? There's a sister. And if the sister carried out this order, yeah, whoever this white guy is. But like, for real though, like, it probably was a woman who did this. She's probably using Mia as leverage, right? Or, I'm sorry, Maya. The defendant. There's a twin? I think so. Isn't the name of the chapter like something sisters? Regardless, there's a sister, right? So if anything, she's probably going to like maybe put some truth into her lie. I don't know. If I question it, I'll probably end up badgering her again, so I don't want to do that. Turnabout sisters, okay. Unless the sister's referring to Maya and Mia, right. Oh, okay. Fuck it! I question the testimony. Hold on a minute! That testimony stinks! What? Miss May, I'm willing to bet that... I never know where they're gonna go with this whenever I choose something. I never know where they're gonna go with it. You're lying. Are you telling me the truth? Did you really see the defendant?
Mr. Mr. Wright, what's the meaning of this?
Yes, what is the meaning? Somebody tell me, because I'm clueless about this.
Okay. If you had really witnessed my client, Maya Fey, you would have noticed her clothes before noticing her physique. Good point, Phoenix. I thought women were supposed to know these things. No one wears clothes like this on a daily basis, except her. And I'm no expert on fashion, but her hairdo looks far from normal to me. However, the witness's testimony mentions neither of these things. The testimony is bogus.
But...
Still, we don't know if she was dressed that way the night of the murder.
She was, Your Honor. I saw her. And so did Detective Gumshoe.
Yes.
What do you say to that, Miss May?
Rawr! What are you trying to say, you mean lawyer? I saw what I saw. I just didn't think all the trifling little details were necessary, darling.
Miss May, the court would like to remind you to please omit nothing in your testimony.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. I'll be a good girl. I promise. Wink.
Your testimony again, if you would.
Damn, I almost had her. I thought we did. Oh, well, we did, but we are moving on to the next testimony, so that's good. That's good.
I did see everything. I did. The victim, the woman, dodged the first attack and ran... Okay, the victim, the woman, dodged the first attack and ran off to the right.
Yeah, can you imagine, like, in an actual witness testimony, someone just going, rawr! That would be rich. Oh, wow. I guess she would have seen a slump from this vision. Oh, wait a minute. The woman dodged the first attack and ran off to the right. Keep that in mind. Then the girl in the hippie clothes ran after her.
And she hit her with that weapon. I saw it. I did.
That, the clock, the kind of statue-y clock? The thinker, I think?
Well, does the accuracy of my report not startle you?
How does she know it was a clock? How did she know it was a clock? When everybody else keeps referring to it as a statue.
I see. I only wish you had been so detailed from the beginning. Please begin the cross-examination.
Oh, thank you, Torland. Yeah, she's the only one here who didn't call it a statue, right? Let's try it. Miss May, what you said just now was quite revealing.
Revealing? Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you, naughty Mr. Lawyer?
You just said that this statue of the thinker was a clock.
Yeah,
but there's no way of knowing that just by looking at it. Another person in much the same position as you recently called this a clock, too.
Yes, cutting right to the chase, Braydeck.
Yeah! And he was found guilty of murder. Oh, shit. Let's go.
Order.
Miss May, can you explain how you know this was a clock?
Oh,
Objection.
The witness saw the murder with her own eyes. That's all that's important here. But you must remember, the only way to know it's a clock is by tilting it.
The defense is trying to confuse the issue with trivial concerns. Yes, of course. You will withdraw your question, Mr. Wright.
No, yes, object.
But questions are all I have, Your Honor. And as you may recall,
I've caught murderers with these questions before. Well, only once. And Judge, you were there! You know that the clock has to be tilted.
Hmm. Objection sustained. You may continue to question the witness.
Thank you, Your Honor. Whew, that was close. If he stopped me there, the trial would be over. Huh? What? So what happens now? What happens now is you answer my question. Did you know, how did you know it was a clock? What? That's... Because I heard it? Yes, I heard it say the time. So, you've been to the law offices of Fay and Company. No! Hey, I didn't say that! Why would I go there? I heard it from my hotel room. The law offices of Fay and Company, where the murder took place, is very close to the hotel. She could easily have heard the clock.
Well, Mr. Wright, are you satisfied?
Good. No, Your Honor. I can't give up now. I'm not satisfied because... Hold on, let me think about this. The murderer tilted it down, right? You have to tilt it down in order to hear the time. Crap, this is crucial. I can't get this wrong. Check my notes. Oh, man. I hope you're not referring to the notes from last time, because I don't know where they are. I do know that. I mean, how could she have heard it from across the street? With all that commotion, right? Something in your evidence here. True. It's not working! It's not working! It's not working! It couldn't have rung! Thank you, cell phone! Whew. Your Honor, members of the court. It is inconceivable that the clock in question rang. It's broken. I think it's broken. That clock's busted.
You think?
No, Phoenix, why'd you say that? Just look at it. Your Honor, please examine the clock. Bro, no! We have evidence! Oh! See anything interesting, Your Honor?
Well, I'm not sure I would call this broken, but I doubt it could ring. This clock is missing its clockwork. It's quite empty.
Oh, thank God. That made me nervous.
Mr. Wright, would you care to explain to the court the meaning of this?
It is as you can see. It was empty, but good save. Whew, okay, yeah, for real. The clock was empty. It couldn't have rung. Therefore, this witness is a big, fat liar. Fat? Well, Miss May? Tisk tisk. Quite a show you've put on for us, Mr. Wright. He knew the clock was empty. Somehow, he knew. I'm afraid you've forgotten one thing, however. Indeed, the clock is empty. As you say, it can't ring. However, we must ask, when was the clockwork removed? If it was after the witness heard the clock, then there is no contradiction. If it was after the witness heard the clock, then there is no contradiction. No, it was before. We have evidence!
Oh, that's true. That is a possibility. The clock must have been emptied after she heard it.
And that is exactly what happened, Your Honor.
Well, Mr. Wright, can you prove when the clockwork was removed?
Yes!
Ho ho, impossible, of course.
I have proof.
What? Wasn't it you who told me proof is everything?
Well, I was listening.
And now I'll show you the proof you like so much.
The evidence that proves when the clockwork was removed is... right here.
Take that!
Take a look at this.
That's a very cute cell phone.
Oh, you have a girly phone.
Wait, this isn't my phone. Listen. This is the defendant's cell phone, and it contains a recording. A recording of a conversation she had with the victim on the day of the murder.
Order! The defendant's cell phone? This isn't brought to my attention!
Perhaps Detective Gumshoe overlooked it.
Grr, the good detective better remember he's up for evaluation soon.
I gotta say, I'm starting to feel bad for the big fella. Let's hear the conversation.
So you just want me to hold on to the thinker for you then? If you could. I should probably tell you, the clock isn't talking right now. Huh? It's not working. That's lame. Yeah, I had to take the clockwork out. Sorry.
September 5th, 9:27 a.m. I really hope that they don't turn that against Mia, that she had to take the clockwork out for any particular reason.
No, they wouldn't do that.
I mean, they could, but how would that be relevant, you know? Your Honor, I think this makes it clear the clockwork was already gone by the time this was recorded. Which was well before the witness even arrived at her hotel. Well, Miss May, would you care to explain this to the court? Just how did you know that the weapon was a clock?
isn't it obvious? I saw that clock before. What store was that again? I go to so many.
It wasn't made at a store, sis.
Oops, I forgot. Wink.
So the witness had seen it before. That would make sense. Does the defense have any objections, Mr. Wright?
Yes! The witness claims she had seen it before. But this directly contradicts a piece of evidence already submitted to this court.
Well then, let's see it. Please produce this evidence that will prove the witness had not seen the clock before.
Made by Larry Butts.
Take that!
It's simple. This clock was never in any store, ever.
What?
A friend of mine made that clock. Only two exist in the world. And the one that isn't here is in police custody.
Impossible! Everything is sold in stores!
Miss May, I think it's high time you went shopping for a better excuse.
Oh, Phoenix.
It's pretty good.
Oomph.
Oh? Excuse is not on sale today? Oh! Phoenix! You're killing her out there!
Oh?
Yeah, that's what she just did. That sound right there.
Ooh! What's it to you, porcupine head? That stupid clock doesn't matter, okay? She did it, and she should die for it! Die!
Whoa! Let's not get ahead of ourselves! This is a court of law, and the witness will remain calm!
Oh. A silly me. Did I, lose it? I guess I did. Wink.
Scary. Miss May, let me ask. Tell me, how did you know the weapon was a clock? Oh dear. Does the defense have an opinion on this? Behavior.
Okay, this is it. Yes, Your Honor, allow me to explain how I see the truth of the matter. Miss April May,
You knew the weapon was a clock because... Well, she couldn't have held it. I mean, she was, like, over there. She heard about it! The wiretap! The witness had never held the clock in her hand. However, she had heard that it was a clock.
She heard?
That is correct, Your Honor. There is no other way she could have known the thinker was a clock. And I could show you the proof.
Well, this is interesting. Let's see it then. Show me evidence proving that the witness had heard the murder weapon was a clock.
Right here, Your Honor. The wiretap. Bam, baby, let's go.
Take that.
Have a look at this.
Ah! Oh, that?
I found this in Miss May's room.
Mr. Wright, please explain to the court what this is.
Miss April May, you were tapping the victim, Miss Mia Faye's phone, were you not?
Oh!
Your Honor, this is irrelevant.
I'm not entirely sure that it is. Objection overruled.
Yeah, get him, Judge.
All right. It troubles me that our witness was in possession of a wiretap.
Yeah, for real, though. Yeah.
This is outrageous. Does the defense truly claim that the witness was tapping her phone?
Absolutely.
Even if that was the case, which it's not, you still have to prove one thing. Did the victim ever say that the weapon was a clock on the phone?
Did the victim ever say that the weapon was a clock on the phone? Again, what is it this time? It's a clock. Did the victim... It's made to look like the statue.
Yeah, it's a clock. They literally say that. I had to take the clockwork out, yada, yada, yada. Like, yeah.
Freideck, yeah, it's true. Edgeworth isn't the only one who doesn't share evidence.
Yeah, you got us. You got us on that one.
Yeah, it would have to be this. We got that, right?
Yeah.
Did the victim ever say that the weapon was a clock on the phone?
Can you prove that? I think not.
Oh yeah?
I think I can. It's simple.
What?
Here's my proof.
The proof that the victim said on the phone that the weapon was a clock is... It's the cell phone. Please be the right thing. I hope I'm not overthinking. It's the cell phone.
Take that!
I present the defendant's cell phone.
Yes, we've seen that.
Listen once more to the conversation between the defendant and the victim.
Mia, what's up? You haven't called in a while.
Well, actually, there's something I want you to hold on to for me.
Again? What is it this time?
It's a clock. It's made to look like that statue, the thinker, and it tells you the time.
Miss April May, you used a wiretap to listen to this conversation. That's how you knew the thinker was a clock. Am I wrong?
I...
Objection!
Your Honor, this is ridiculous. Your Honor, look at the witness's face. Does she seem amused to you? The defense demands an answer.
Witness, answer the question. Did you tap her phone? Miss May!
Shut up, all of you! What gives you the right to talk to me like that? You lawyer!
Oh boy.
It's no fair. All of you ganging up on me like that. Oh, so I'm the bad girl. Is that it? Is that it?
That did it. The court's seen the real Miss April May now. Now to deal the final blow.
Well, no, she didn't do it because she had the wiretap, but, like, or she had the wiretap. She didn't do it, remember? Okay? Why the wiretap? Why did you tap her phone? Answer the question! Do I have to? Isn't this a murder trial? Isn't tippity-tapping irrelevant? God, she's saying exactly what Edgeworth wants her to say. Miss May, you were tapping the victim's phone. I hardly call that irrelevant.
While this court does not condone the defense's tone of voice, he has a point. Well, Miss May, do you have an explanation for the court? Can you prove you had nothing to do with this murder, even though you tapped her phone?
Ha, I'd like to see her pull that off. Phoenix, don't speak too soon, guy. We're still in this.
Mr. Lawyer, I saw that evil, evil grin. You were probably thinking I'd like to see her pull that off, weren't you?
Damn, she's good.
Well, there's not the first man who's thought that. And of course, I can and will.
You can't be serious. No way.
Way, I say. Way! Oh, and I assure you, I'm serious, Mr. Lawyer.
Humph.
Okay, so the killing happened around...
I'm sorry. That freaking expression that she makes when she gets really dark in the face. Oh, that's great. That's great. Okay.
Okay, so the killing happened around 9 at night. Why, that's just when I was getting room service from that sweet bellboy.
Room service?
Iced coffee, I believe it was. Iced coffee, you know? Like normal coffee, but cold. If you don't drink it quick, the ice melts and then you have regular cold coffee.
Iced coffee?
Think I'm making this up? Ask the bellboy.
A wink. Wait, is he here?
Ergo, the witness was not on the scene at the time of the murder.
So, where does that leave us?
It is my great displeasure to inform you that the witness appears to have been tapping the victim's telephone. However, that is a separate crime with no bearing on the current case whatsoever.
Damn, though. That is a good play, Edgeworth.
Her testimony stands. She saw the defendant, Maya Faye, commit murder.
Damn, which is the whole purpose of the whole thing anyways. Damn it, Edgeworth, you're good.
No, they're going to just let her walk away. There's no way I can win this unless I tie Miss May to the murder. Somehow.
Screwdriver. Screwdriver.
Well, does the defendant have anything to say?
Well,
come on, think of something.
This is crucial. No, they really did, Brydeck. That's what makes the dialogue so fun to read. They did a really good job. It's a really good court drama. Like, seriously, this is fun. Oh, man. And the puns. That's right. Good puns. We could call the bellboy as a witness. We could probably contradict something with that. God, I should have taken notes from the bellboy. I thought I had a day off today. Now I'm back in court. Sonny, do you work in a courtroom? Is this what you do for a living? That's news to me. Dang, that's actually kind of cool. Sometimes? Are you a court secretary? Like, what's your gig? Damn, what should I do? I'm trying to remember anything that the bellboy had told us. He had told us about drinks that he served. God, there must be something.
I just wish we had the screwdriver. Like, why don't we have the screwdriver on us? I thought for sure I could pick that up. I mean, I guess, okay, well, I guess the screwdriver doesn't matter because she used that to do the wiretap, right? So... how many drinks did he serve? Right. And I do remember seeing bottled wine, not coffee. I don't know if that matters, but there was bottled wine for two. For two. I'm something like a lawyer, says Sonny. Mostly I try to deal the things without a court. Ah, I see. Okay. Really interesting, Sonny. How long did you go to law school? Let's call the bellboy as a witness. Because I remember there were two bottles. There was a bottle of wine and two glasses. It was intended for two people. Who was that second person? Were they planning to do a cheers if everything worked out? Moobot, how did you miss that? Moobot, you sleeping? All right, let's see. Let's call the bellboy as a witness. The defense would like to call the bellboy as a witness. There's something suspicious here, and I'm going to get to the bottom of it. I think you've sunk in quite low enough already.
Objection!
I object to calling the bellboy. But why? What's your reason? Because I hold that the wiretapping had nothing to do with the killing. Shit. However, if you agree to one condition, I'll consent to calling this witness. Ah, Saber. Good point. Good point. It got past the automated defenses. Ah! I left a hole in the fence. I gotta fix it. I'll do it later. I could finish my studies in 4 years. Okay. That's cool, Sonny. Dang, I didn't know that about you. That's awesome. Learn more about you today, Sonny. That's dope. That's cool. Well, let's see what this condition is. If Miss April May's alibi is not called into question after you examine the bellboy, then you will recognize that Miss April May was not the killer. Thus, she is innocent. And thereby, you must also accept the verdict of guilty for Miss Maya Fay. That is my condition. What? I'd better find something suspicious in that bellboy's testimony. Otherwise, Maya will be declared guilty on the spot. What should I do? Oh. I swear it has to do with the drinks. All right, I've got nothing to lose, except for, well, everything. Understood, I accept your condition. Fool, you fell right into my trap. Uh-oh, wait. Very well, the court calls the hotel bellboy to the stand. If you give up, she gets guilty. If you try, you may save her. I don't know why Nick even thinks of it. Well, we'll see how it goes. I believe we're ready for the witness to testify. He certainly does look like a bellboy. Yes, sir. I received your summons in the middle of work, sir. I'm happy to be of service. That tea set looks rather heavy, so without further ado, the witness may begin his testimony. Very good, sir. I am the head bellboy at the fine Gatewater Hotel, in business for 4 generations. I believe I received a call after 8 in the evening from our guest, Miss May. Okay, 8 in the evening from our guest, Miss May. She asked for an iced coffee to be brought to her at 9 on the dot, sir. Okay, so the iced coffee thing did happen. I brought it to her precisely the requested time, of course. and I delivered the iced coffee to our guest, Miss May, herself.
I see. The defense begin its cross-examination.
Oh, boy. All right, here we go. This is it. If I can't prove Miss May was involved with the murder now, Maya will be finished. Oh, boy. Okay. At 9 p.m., right, when she saw the murder. Right. That's what I was trying to remember. Yeah, thank you for mentioning that. So it was 9 p.m. when she saw the murder. He had mentioned 8 in the evening from our guest, Miss May. She asked for an iced coffee to be brought to her at 9 on the dot. Clock. Right? He gave it to her personally. It looked like she stepped outside at 9 o'clock when it was given, right? So how would she have seen this go down if she was grabbing the iced coffee at 9 o'clock? I'm gonna press him on this.
Hold it!
9 on the dot, you say?
Yes, I confirmed that detail several times. She was watching a program on the TV and wished to drink after she finished, sir.
9, the time of the murder.
Yes, Phoenix, yes, precisely.
Hold it!
Precisely 9, then.
Precisely,
exactly. And most definitely, sir, 9 p.m. How could he be so sure?
Miss May was quite insistent that it be brought then.
Oh, bellboy, I'd like iced coffee at exactly 9.
Something like that, sir.
Therefore, I knocked on her door at the crack of 9, sir.
Why would she be so particular about the time?
You are sure it was Miss April May herself?
Oh, Phoenix.
Absolutely, sir.
Absolutely?
Yes, sir. As in, so very absolutely, sir. It's an endearing mannerism of mine.
How come you're so very certain?
Well, when I brought the room service, sir.
Oh, boy. What a face.
The guest, sir. She favored me with, an embracer, sir?
Embracer? Is that French for embrace?
It's French for kiss, sir. But not a French kiss, sir. More of a peck on the cheek.
Why would she have done that?
I believe perhaps she was momentarily swayed by my prim demeanor, sir.
These characters.
It was a moment I shall never, ever forget, sir.
This sounds pretty fishy to me. I think our Miss May was up to something and wanted the bellboy to remember her. But why?
It's no good. There's nothing there. Is that it?
Finally, you understand. This bellboy had absolutely no reason to lie. Now, if you have any decency, you will end this rather tedious cross-examination here.
It was a bit tedious. The witness may leave the stand. I can't let this happen, can I?
There's something fishy going on, right? Protest! Wait! Please wait!
Yes? Does the defense have something to add?
One last question. Let me ask one last question.
Objection!
Your Honor, I must object. This charade of justice has gone on long enough.
Now, now, Mr. Edgeworth. All right, Mr. Wright. I'll give you one more question, that's all.
Okay. This is really it. Now, this is my last chance. What do I ask him about?
Bed-making? Phoenix could apparently use some pointers. Ha ha ha.
We should probably press on the room service, right? Because that's crucial. The fact that all of this is happening while the murder is going down.
This is a really big think, Jickwood. This is a really big think.
I mean, why would the check-in be relevant? Okay, room service. Tell me again about room service.
Again, sir.
At exactly 9, I delivered room service to Miss May in room 303.
I'm not missing any details, you guys. Exactly 9. Room 303.
The guest had requested iced coffee. $18 at the charge, I recall.
$18 iced coffee.
I see. $18? Doesn't that seem a bit expensive?
Phoenix.
Yes, well, iced coffee for two, you know. For two!
For two. That's what I've been waiting for. Something to mention a potential other person.
What did he say? What did you say?
Ah, oh, rather quiet.
Bellboy, tell us the truth. Now. Was someone else staying in Miss May's room?
Objection!
I object. That was objectionable. Objection overruled. The witness will answer the question.
Yes, I see.
Why did you not mention this in your testimony?
Sir, you didn't ask.
Nice try. That's the sort of thing you're normally supposed to mention.
Yes, quite, indeed. It was the, good barrister there, Mr. Edgeworth, who...
He asked me not to mention it if I wasn't specifically asked, sir.
You just threw him under the bus, dude?
No! You fool! Well, I've done it. I've won! Miss April May checked into a twin room with a man, correct?
Yes, sir.
Then when you brought them room service, you didn't see that man in the room.
That's right, sir.
Your Honor, we have just learned of another person involved who may have been the murderer. In light of this new fact, I told...
I hold that it's impossible to judge the defendant. Wouldn't you agree, Mr. Edgeworth?
And who, Mr. Wright? Who is this other person?
Simple. It was...
I mean, she did give him a kiss on the cheek. Miss April May and her male twin, Miss April May.
Oh my gosh. I actually didn't think of it that way, but that's like, that's funny. I didn't even notice that. I was looking at these other two. That's brilliant. Good answer. Pressing X. Like, oh. Okay, let's see. I mean, we talked about earlier how with the bellboy, she was giving him a kiss on the cheek. She was like, you know, getting all lovey-dovey on him. You know what I mean? She wanted him there precisely at 9. Iced coffee for 2. Phoenix also mentions that she wanted him to remember her, right? Why? Why would she be being all lovey-dovey with him? We don't know who the other man is. The only other suspect we have would potentially be the bellboy. But then again, the bellboy couldn't have done it, right? Because the bellboy was with her at 9 o'clock. This is crucial. I can't mess this up. I wish I could reread the dialogue. I wish I could reread what was just said. Hang on. I'm getting confused. I need to go to the VOD real quick. I can do that. I'm just gonna go see what the previous set of dialogue was. Otherwise, I'd be screwed. Okay. Okay, here we go. You fool. I've done it. I've won. Miss April May checked into a twin room with a man. Correct. Yes, sir. Then, when you brought them room service, you didn't see that man in the room. That's right, sir. Your Honor, we have just learned of another person involved who may have been the murderer. Torland, who is more suspicious, the average worker or the mysterious man whose existence has been kept hidden from us? You got a very good point, Torland. Because, yeah, like, okay. I just want to make sure I got this right. Then when you brought them room service, you didn't see that man in the room. That's right. You didn't see that man in the room. The man that was the man that was with Miss May. Oh shit. The authorities are here. Run! Run! Run, it's gamers! Stop all the wrongdoings and the shady things. We have a real mod in our presence. Yeah, it's 7 a.m. What are you talking about, gamers? Come on. Get with it, man. Come on.
Give it the right time zone, okay? Good to see you, bud. Hope you're doing well. Wish you had the police emote. I mean, we didn't get you one. Just for you. All right, man. The man that was with Miss May. The man who checked in with Miss May. Ugh! Your Honor, as had been previously revealed, Miss April May was tapping the victim's phone. Yet Miss May herself was an alibi at the time of the murder. However, that does not clear the man that was with her. The bellboy saw no one else in the room at the time of the murder. My, what a convenient little setup, but it's too late. Too late? I suppose you'd like it if it was too late, wouldn't you? After all, it was you who hid the presence of the other man from this court. Oh! Upstart! Amateur! These accusations are ludicrous! Enough. The court acknowledges the defense's argument. I expect the prosecution and defense to look into this matter fully. And am I understood? Yes. Yes, Your Honor. That is all today for the trial of Maya Faye. Court is adjourned. Dang. We did it. Wow. September 7th, 2:24 p.m. District Court. Defendant Lobby, number 1. Dude. Wow. That was incredible.
Mr. Wright! You were amazing in there!
Really?
Yeah, I think I might be your newest fan!
Oh, I was just doing my job, you know? Then again, that other attorney was pretty cool too.
Huh?
That face of his, with his eyes wide and trembling lips?
It sent shivers up my spine!
If you say so.
So, what happens with me? Do I get to go home now?
Well, no, I don't think so. Not yet.
Oh, I see.
But I got a great lead in today's trial.
A lead?
That man with Miss May. He's the key.
Oh, I get it.
What happened to Miss May after that, anyway? I heard they arrested her. I guess she's learning her charms won't work everywhere. She's probably at the detention center right now. I may have to go down there later. Anyway, this case is far from closed.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to find out more about this man.
Do you think he was the one who...
Maybe so.
Sis.
Don't worry. I'll find him by tomorrow, I promise.
I'm counting on you.
I asked for a full record of April May's testimony. I thought it might come in handy during the trial tomorrow. But now that I have it, I'm not so sure. Most of her testimony was all lies. In fact, there's only one part that hasn't been stricken from the record. Okay, the victim...
Yes, yes, thank you, thank you. I remember this. The victim dodged an attack, then ran to the right, but she was caught and struck.
In my mind, if she saw the victim slump over, how would she have seen it if she ran over to the right? I mean, I guess it didn't necessarily detail that she was on the right side of the window, right? But that's what's in my head right now. I'm sure we'll go over that evidence in a little bit. Well, next time, rather. I don't know how much good this will do me at all now. Anyway, time to hit the pavement and do some investigating. Maya doesn't belong in that detention center, and it's up to me to set her free. Dude. This game's cool, man. This game is cool. Oh, man. Oh, man, this game is cool. I am loving it. And I love reading it. I'm like immersed into the dialogue when I read it. And it feels like I'm watching this really good court drama with great comedy. I don't know. This is wonderful. And I'm just starting. Oh, my gosh. I bet it gets even better. It's so good. And then when the tension starts amping up, And the witnesses start breaking down, or like watching Edgeworth getting really intense. First, that was fun to read. I loved reading it when Edgeworth was getting like, gah! But like, dude,
Oh, man, you just feel the energy. You feel the energy of the back and forth of the dialogue. It's so good. It's so good. I'm enjoying this. This is a blast. And there's more where that came from. There's, like, so much more of this series. Like, dude, this is cool. This is really cool. Did I save it right? 1351. No. Let me save it just in case. Got it. Okay. All right. Okay. We saved it, so I think I'm going to stop it here. That was good. That was really good. In fact, yeah, we ended at a perfect 2 hours. I thought it was going to be a little longer, but, like, that was a perfect run. I don't think we got penalized once. That, what a good start to this particular chapter. That was our first trial, so there's more to this chapter, of course, but so far, we're in good, and, yeah. Yes, Torland. Oh, yes, yes. Go sleep. Go get rest. Thank you for hanging out with us. I'm glad we can make it happen. I was planning on doing this tomorrow, for those that don't know, but things got booked up. So I will be available. The next stream will be on Sunday. I'll be doing my push to 100% Outriders. Not sure what the next weekend looks like at the moment. I don't think Saturday is clear. Friday is a maybe. I'm not sure. I will let y'all know when I decide to do the next Phoenix Wright stream. And Torland, I'll definitely reach out to you about it too. But yeah, no, I'm glad this worked out. This was a lot of fun. I am enjoying this game. Absolutely enjoying it. Yes, praise the sun. That's right. Listen, dude, Hectic, it was really good meeting you. And I don't want to name drop, but you know who you are. It was good meeting you guys this evening. And again, really good burgers. Really good burgers. Yes, y'all take care of yourselves. Yeah, again, I will be live on Sunday, probably maybe either 10 a.m. Central or 5 p.m. Central. I know that's a big leap, but it really just depends on what's going on Sunday. So I'll keep y'all posted in the Discord and whatnot and all that good stuff. But in the meantime, let's go see a Wicked Raider host. At the very least, let's go see a Wicked Raider host. If it's a friend of mine, I raid them. But if there's no friend streaming, we're going to drop a host on someone I follow. Let's see who it's going to be tonight. Who do we got? Oh, Nady's live. Okay, so Nady, for those that don't know, this is one of our community members, Nady Cat. And they've been streaming lately, which is really cool. They're currently playing Relic Hunters. Not sure what this is, but it's a thing. And we're going to give Nady the raid tonight. So I think that's what's going to happen. Let's make it happen. Nady Cat 99, get that thing on the room. Yeah, I'm going to do it. Get the raid. Six of us. Seven of us. Good number, good number. Going once, going twice, and sold. Listen, peace of God bless. Thank y'all for hanging out. Love y'all very much, and can't wait to do it again soon. Let's give Nady some love, and y'all have a good night. Let's go.